Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all are fit and fine at your homes and you all are taking a good care of yourself. So children, let us start today's mathematics class of grade 10th. Children, in today's video, I am going to discuss the solutions of revision assignment of chapter number 8, trigonometry, and chapter number 9, application of trigonometry. Okay, children? Children, after watching this video, definitely it is going to help you to resolve your doubts, whatever doubts you will be having related to revision assignment. And definitely it will help you to check your, you are supposed to cross check your solutions also after watching this video. Fine. And definitely all the errors, whatever you are finding in your solutions, they all will be rectified after watching this video. So children, our first question is from basic trigonometry. Simplify tangent theta plus 2 into tangent theta plus 1 is equal to 5 tangent theta plus secant square theta. We have to prove whether left hand side is equal to right hand side or not. So here is the solution of question number 1. I am going to take left hand side. Here you can see that there are two expressions in the bracket. So when I multiplied them, I got 2 tan square theta plus 10 theta plus 4 tan theta plus 2. This 10 theta plus 4 tan theta will become 5 tan theta, correct? 2 tan square theta plus 2 will be written together. From here, I have taken 2 as common. So children, there is one identity of trigonometric ratios. Sec square theta minus 10 square theta is equal to 1. So if I am going to take 10 square on right hand side, I will get sec square theta is equal to 1 plus 10 square theta. So at place of 1 plus 10 square theta, I have written here 2 secant square theta. This is sec square is the short form of secant square theta plus 5 tangent theta. But here have a look children. What do I want? I want 5 tan theta, which I have got, plus sec square theta only, not twice of sec square theta. So it means LHS is not equal to RHS. Understood? Now children, this is our question number 2. Simplify sine cube theta plus cos cube theta upon sine theta plus cos theta plus sine theta into cos theta. We have to simplify this expression and we have to calculate its value. So children, cross check its solution please. Here I am going to apply a cube plus b cube, that is a plus b means sine theta plus cos theta into a square plus b square minus ab. That is sine square theta plus cos square theta minus sine theta into cos theta. Or at denominator, sine theta plus cos theta will be written as it is. And along with it plus sine theta cos theta. Correct? Children, you know there is identity sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So I have written sine theta plus cos theta as it is. 1 minus sine into cos upon sine plus cos. Here it is written plus sine theta into cos theta, this as it is. Sine theta plus cos theta is going to be cancelled. So what I have got 1 minus sine theta into cos theta plus sine theta into cos theta. So again, they both are also going to be cancelled. So what is the answer? Answer is 1. Now children, our question number third is whole under root 1 minus cos square theta into sec square theta is equal to tangent theta. Children, if you know about the trigonometric ratios, their identities, their values at the specific angles, so definitely these questions will be very simple for you. Okay. So here have a look. Here I have applied sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. How? If I want the value of 1 minus cos square theta, so that will be sine square theta only. So let us insert this value over here. Into sec square theta. Children, you know that secant theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. So at place, so 1 upon secant square theta, I can write 1 upon cos square theta, and then here complete expression will be in whole under root. Correct? You know that sine theta upon cos theta is what? That is tangent theta. So sine square theta upon cos square theta will be tangent square theta and having whole under root. So it will come out, that tangent theta will come out only. So what will be the answer, children? The answer will be tangent theta, correct? Which is equal to right hand side. So hence proved. Now children, let us switch to question number 4. Show that tangent A upon 1 plus secant A minus tangent A upon 1 minus secant A is equal to 2 upon sine A. Correct? So children, here you can see that left hand side is in the form of P upon Q with minus sign inside. So these are fractional numbers, fractional expressions, they are with minus sign. So how can I simplify it? Definitely I have to take LCM. So here is the solution. 1 plus secant A into 1 minus secant A will be LCM. 1 plus secant A, 1 plus secant A cancel. So tangent A will be multiplied by 1 minus secant A. This is minus sign. Now tangent A into 1 plus secant A will be written because this will be cancelled. Now let us multiply. It would become 10A minus 10A into secant A minus 10A minus 10A into secant A. 10A and 10A are going to be cancelled. So I have got minus 1 10A into secant A minus 1 10A into secant A. So that would become minus 2 10A into secant A upon. At denominator, children, I am going to take minus 1 as common. So that identity, that is secant square theta minus 10 square theta, or I can write 10 square A also, is equal to 1, can be applied easily. Correct? So here I have minus and minus will be cancelled. 2 10A into secant A upon. Look, secant square theta minus 1 is equal to what? That is 10 square theta. Means 10 square A. 1 10 is going to be cancelled. So I have got 2 secant A upon 10A. Children, you know that secant A is equal to 1 upon cos A. Secant and cos theta are reciprocal of each other. Fine. So I have written 2 upon cos A, or sine, tangent A I know that is sine upon cos A. Let us take reciprocal. So I have got 2 upon sine A, which is RHS. Okay. Suppose if RHS is 2 cosecant A, will it be right or wrong? Yes, it will be right. Why? Because 1 upon sine A is nothing but cosecant A. Cosecant and sine A are also reciprocal of each other. Correct? So till here the answer will be finished. Now children, our next question is from its application. Find the height of a mountain if the elevation of its top at an unknown distance from the base is 30 degree. The angle of elevation is given to you. Fine. That is 30 degree. And at a distance 10,000 meter further off from the mountain along the same line. Now the angle of elevation is going to be changed. So now what is the angle of elevation? That is 15 degree after covering the distance of 10,000 meter. Or here as a clue it is given that use tangent 15 degree is equal to 0.27. Because we do not know the value of tangent theta at 15 degree angle. So children, here is the diagram of solution number 5. Here you can see that I have assumed the height of the mountain, that is h meter. And if the elevation of its top at an unknown distance, we do not know what is the distance from the base, correct? So it is going to be formed 30 degree angle. But later when it is going to be covered 10,000 meter distance, So the angle of elevation is going to be reduced, that is 15 degree. Correct? So let us apply trigonometry now. In triangle QPR, perpendicular upon base, that is H upon X, is equal to tangent 30. Tangent 30 is equal to 1 upon root 3. So while cross multiplying, I have got X is equal to root 3 H. Let it consider as equation number 1. Now let us choose another right angle triangle, that is QPS. It will be perpendicular upon base once again. That is H upon X plus 10,000 is equal to tangent 15 degree. In question we were given the value of tangent 15 degree, that is 0.27. Correct? When I cross multiplied, I got 0.27, the value of tangent 15, into X plus 10,000. Correct? So from here the value of X I am going to insert over here, so that the complete equation will be in H and we will be able to calculate the height of the mountain, which is considered as H meters. Correct? Now it is just a simple calculation. 0.27 into root 3H plus 0.27 into 10,000. Removing decimal, cancelling, I have got 2700 here. And this will be written as it is. Now H and H will be placed together. So I am going to take 0.27 root 3H on left hand side. So while taking it on left hand side, it will become minus of 0.27 root 3. Here there was 1 written. So definitely if you are going to take H common, it will be 1 minus 0.27 root 3 into H is equal to 2700. Children, the value of root 3 is 1.732. You must remember the values of few irrational numbers like root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7. That would really help you. Otherwise, sometimes it is given in the question itself. Okay. So, when I multiply 0.27 by 1.732, I got 0.46. So, I have got 1 minus 0.46 into H is equal to 2700. While subtracting it, I got 0.54. It is multiplying with H on left hand side. It must be divided on right hand side. So after removing decimal, there will be 2 more zeros at the numerator along with 2700. So 27 ones are here, 27 twos are, that is 54. Now 2 ones are, this 10,000 will be cancelled. It will become 5,000. So this was H. So H is nothing but the height of the mountain, that is 5,000 meters. Got it? Now children, our question number 6 is also again from application of trigonometry. The height of a lighthouse is H meters. From this lighthouse, the angles of depression of two ships on the opposite side of it are observed to be 30 degree and 45 degree. These are angles of depression. Means in this case the observer is at the top of the terrace or of the building of the lighthouse. So find the distance between two ships. Children, let me remind you one thing. If in application of trigonometry you are capable to form the appropriate diagram, then definitely you will be able to get full mark in this question. Fine. So here you can see that the height of a lighthouse is H meter. Okay, from this lighthouse, the angle of depressions, means right now the observer is here. The angle of depressions are going to be formed, that is 30 degree and 45. You know that this line and this line, means let it be line L, is parallel to PQ. So AP will enact as transversal. As 30 degree is angle of depression, so 30 degree will become angle of elevation as well. In the same manner for 45 degree also. Correct? So now apply trigonometry in triangle ABP, perpendicular upon base, that is tangent 30. It will be 1 by root 3, that is H upon X is equal to 1 by root 3. Cross multiply, you will be getting X is equal to root 3 H. Consider it as equation number 1. Now in triangle ABQ, अगेन परपेंडिकुलर अपॉन बेस एच अपॉन वाई इज इक्वल टू टेंजेंट 45, टेंजेंट 45 इज 1, सो इट मीन्स एच इज इक्वल टू वाई और वाई इज इक्वल टू एच. इक्वेशन नंबर 2. इट वॉज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन दैट यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू शिप्स विच आर ऑन द ऑपोजिट साइड ओके ऑफ द लाइट हाउस. दिस इज लाइट हाउस, वन इज हेयर, अनदर इज हेयर. सो मीन्स वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट पी क्यू डिस्टेंस दैट इज पी बी प्लस बी क्यू. सो जस्ट सिंपली एट एक्स एंड वाई, सो यू विल बी गेटिंग रूट थ्री एच प्लस एच. लेट अस टेक एच इज कॉमन. सो द डिस्टेंस पी क्यू और आई शुड से दैट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू शिप्स इज रूट थ्री प्लस वन मीटर्स. गॉट इट? सो चिल्ड्रन हेयर वेन आई टुक एच कॉमन सो एच विल ऑल्सो बी रिटन अलोंग विद इट. सो द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू शिप्स इज रूट थ्री प्लस वन इन ब्रैकेट इन टू एच मीटर्स. ओके, नाउ लेट अस स्विच टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. प्रूव दैट साइन स्क्वायर 50 डिग्री प्लस साइन स्क्वायर 40 डिग्री प्लस सीकेंट स्क्वायर थीटा माइनस कोट स्क्वायर 90 डिग्री माइनस थीटा अपॉन कोसेक स्क्वायर 57 डिग्री माइनस 10 स्क्वायर 33 डिग्री इज इक्वल टू 2. सो चिल्ड्रन आफ्टर ऑब्जर्विंग इट यू कैन इजिली जज दैट हेयर आई हैव टू अप्लाई करेक्ट दैट इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट लॉज बिकॉज 50 प्लस 40 इज मेकिंग 90, 57 प्लस 33 इज ऑल्सो मेकिंग 90 डिग्री करेक्ट. थीटा प्लस 90 माइनस थीटा इज ऑल्सो फॉर्मिंग मीन्स देयर सम इज 90 डिग्री करेक्ट. If you know the complement law, question will be finished in 3 to 4 steps only. Look, sine square 50 degree, here I have applied complement law. I know that sine 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. So at place of sine square, I have written cos square and complement of 50 degree will be 40 degree plus. This will be written as it is. I explained you that whenever we have to apply complement law, we apply in either of the two trigonometric ratios. Similarly, sec square theta is written as it is minus cot 90 minus theta. Children, here I have written the rule also, whatever I have applied. Cot 90 minus theta is tangent theta. So this is cot square, so it will be tangent square theta. Correct? Upon cosec 90 minus theta is sec theta. Yeah. Cosec 90 minus theta is equal to sec theta. Correct. So this is cosec square means I have to take sec square. So I have to take the complement also 57, that will become 33 degree minus tangent square 33 will be written as it is. Got it? So children, there is one identity, secant square theta minus 10 square theta is equal to 1. Here it can be applied. Here also it can be applied because at place of theta there is 33 degree. No worries. Okay. And I know that sine square theta plus cos square theta is also equal to 1. Make sure that theta must be same. Means here 40 degree that should be same. Then you can apply the identity. Similarly here also. It will be 1 plus 1 upon 1 that is 2. So the answer is 2. Now children, this is last question but most important. Prove that 1 plus secant theta minus tangent theta upon 1 plus secant theta plus tangent theta is equal to 1 minus sine theta upon cos theta. Children, whenever you will be having 1 given along with either sine, secant and tangent or cosecant or cotangent, you have to apply identity. So at place of 1, I can write identity that is secant square theta minus 10 square theta. So let us have a look on its solution. So children, here I have taken left hand side. At place of 1, I am writing secant square theta minus 10 square theta. And this will be written as it is, this part. Plus tangent theta minus, plus secant theta minus tangent theta. Upon denominator will also be written as it is. Children, this is a square minus b square. So open it. It will be a plus b into a minus b. That is secant theta plus tangent theta into secant theta minus tangent theta. Plus rest of the expression will be written as it is. Now please observe from this expression number 1, then there is a sign of plus, then expression number 2. What is common? Correct. Secant theta minus tangent theta will be taken as common. So what will be left inside? Secant plus tangent, this has gone outside, plus 1 will be left inside the bracket after taking secant theta minus tangent theta as common, because these are two expressions, expression 1, expression 2. Here if it is going to be taken common, so only one will be left. Correct? So after taking secant minus tangent theta as common, I have got secant theta plus tangent theta plus 1. At denominator also the same expression was there, so both are going to be cancelled. So we are left with the secant minus tangent. You know secant is a reciprocal of cos. So secant theta is written 1 upon cos theta minus tangent theta can be written upon as sine upon cos. So let us take cos as LCM. You will get 1 minus sine theta upon cos theta, which is equal to right hand side. Got it, students? So children, that's it for the day. I hope after watching this video, your doubts may have been resolved, as well as the concepts which you may have been forgotten, you have also recalled them. Fine, children? So that's it for the day. Thank you and have a nice day.